Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. I can hardly keep my eyes open. Part of it is just it was an exhausting day today, and the other half is that it's allergy season and my allergy medicine from this morning has worn off and I don't really want to take any more right before bed. So it is what it is, but I want to do this now because if I don't, everything is fresh in my mind right now, and if I don't do it now, I'll totally forget things like I did last time. And anyway, so last video, I talked about we had Charlie went in for an MRI and then he had his echo and what do you call it? EKG. And they said that he is going to need surgery. It's time for him to get his pulmonary valve, but then they need more information and all that. So a lot of people were like, wait, what? Charlie has a heart? Like, what's up with that? People didn't realize it's been so long that a lot of people didn't even realize that Charlie was born with a heart problem. And so if you're new and you are like, what's up with that? I have a whole playlist. I documented the whole thing when he was little. And I have a playlist up here. You can check it out. But long story short, he had two surgeries, one when he was 3 months old, and like every complication happened in that. It was awful. He was on intubated for 18 days in the ICU. We were in the hospital for almost a month. It was horrendous. And then he had a second surgery when he was a year old, and it went beautifully. And now the right side of his heart has gotten just too big, because every time his heart beats currently right now, it regurgitates, meaning like, I don't know how to describe it, like a little blood flow comes back in where our normal hearts don't do that. Does that make sense? Like it pumps and then a little bit comes back in. And that over all these years has caused to the right side of his heart to just to get too big. And it's at the point where he needs a pulmonary valve, because he currently doesn't have a pulmonary valve. So that's the quick scoop of everything. So we had the MRI last time. I think I said all this. I don't know. I'm losing my mind. So today we went in for a special cardiac CT. He got an IV in his arm and he did amazing. They have this neat thing that they didn't used to have. I don't know how many of you have medical kids, but they used to put like this, you know, like the serum stuff, like those stuff, and then they put like a patch thing over it to numb the spot, and it would take like half hour to even start working. Well, now they have this little thing that it's like a pop can sort of, like it goes, it's like long. It is amazing, and it immediately numbs it, and you can just immediately do it. And he is like a rock star. It doesn't bother him at all. He didn't even flinch. Before, he didn't even flinch when it was in his hand. Today, he didn't flinch when it was in his arm. So amazing technology for those of you new at this and worried about going in for the IVs and stuff, because that little pop can thing, the little ch is amazing. I wish I could remember what it was called, but he did amazing. It was awesome. So the IV was because they injected dye into him. So he went into the CT thing. They took pictures of him just regular, and then he has arms up, and I don't know. Andy and I went back into this like area behind, like this room behind, and he was in the room all by himself. And then they would, when they was time for the dye, they told him they injected the dye and they could watch it going. And when it was to the part they needed, they had him hold his breath. And I don't know what that did, but I'm telling you this in case you're doing this with your child, because I would have loved to know this. I Googled this and YouTubed it, trying to see if anybody had a video out here on a cardiac CT for a kid, and there was nothing. So they hold their breath, and it's literally like 10 minutes, maybe the whole thing. It is so fast. And he did awesome. That's all he had to do, was hold his breath for that little bit of time when that dye went through that part. And in his case, they were looking for the right ventricular tract flow, output flow, something like that. And they got what they needed right away. So it was super easy. And he did awesome. And it's not loud like an MRI or anything. It's just very quiet and calming. And there's like lights up there and things for him to look at. It was very calming. So it went really well. And then we went to a stress test. And this is, I should have asked more questions about this. I don't think he should have done this. He was the youngest patient they've ever had do a stress test. He's only 8. And look at these pictures. Like he had this mask on that was like almost like cutting into his eyes, all these leads on him, and he had a bike. And it's like for an 8-year-old to explain like, okay, keep pushing yourself, you know, or go till you can't go anymore. Like they don't know, like an 8-year-old, I don't know. I don't think it was that accurate. And I think it was a lot of hassle trying to teach, they were doing breathing stuff. I don't know. I'm kind of rambling, but I'll put a picture. They had like him initially do the breathing thing with this thing in his mouth, and then they'd plug his nose. And I think 8 is just way too young, and it makes sense. He was the youngest one they've ever had. That is like, yeah, he too little to be doing that. So I don't know. But I hope they got the answers they needed, because I'm really wanting to know what kind of surgery they think he's gonna need. Is it gonna be open heart? Which I'm pretty sure it's gonna be open heart, and he's gonna need a valve. But you never know if they can do something to get him by a few more years. I don't know. There might be something in the cath lab they can do. I don't know. But I just want to know what it is and what the plan is, what kind of valve they're getting. Because there was a new valve that was just FDA approved as of last March. It's called the Harmony valve. And when you read it, it sounds amazing. So I'm just curious if he could get that. So I don't know. So I'm waiting to hear. And then we're actually going to get a second opinion. So from Mayo Clinic. We're going to go to the Mayo Clinic, switch over to the Mayo Clinic and see what they say. For a variety of reasons, but that's just kind of what the plan is. So I don't know if you have any questions. I looked up both stress test, pediatric stress, cardiac stress test, and this, and I just couldn't find anything on YouTube. And I had wished that I could. That's why I'm filming this. I know there's a huge movement on YouTube to not speak about kids or show kids anymore. But in my case, I feel like it's just a little different. Like, this is purely like education and for the people who care about us. And it's not like I'm some huge channel where a gazillion people are following me and I'm not, I don't know. It's not like I show my kids that much. So, you know what I mean? But I know that is like a huge thing right now, is not talking about kids. But I really think that it helps to show other kids what they're gonna go through, and other parents, like, hey, this is what it kind of looks like, this is what we're doing. And I don't know. I just feel like it's more of a help than a harm thing right now. So that's why I'm doing what I'm doing. That was a whole lot of rambling, and I hope I said everything. Oh, he did have to fast for the stress test, but not for the CT. So, and then he's supposed to just like really drink as much fluids, because they want to flush that out of his system, because I guess it's not good for their kidneys, liver, kidneys, something like that. So he needs to drink, which he doesn't drink. So I'm going to try to get him to drink some more stuff tonight. So, all right, that's enough of that. Thank you for watching, guys. I will keep you posted. I don't know when I'll hear. I know they're going to bring his case back to that conference that they did originally, and then they'll come up with a plan. I'm assuming they'll call me. I don't know. Hopefully, I'll hear soon. So, thank you for watching. Thank you for thinking of us and for all the support. I really appreciate it. All right, guys. Bye.